Greetings. I'd like to tell you the parable of the true believers. There was a certain man generations ago who found favor in the eyes of God. The man received a covenant with Almighty God. But the man's neighbors were upset because God blessed the man. The man lived and he died, and God's covenant passed down to his children and his children's children. Many generations passed, and the man's family grew to be a great nation. The neighbors also grew to be a great nation, but not blessed with the covenant. Now God had marked his covenant, requiring the men to shave their heads. So the neighbors shaved their heads too, thinking God could not tell from above who had the covenant and who did not. And God, over time, sent messengers to the family and told them of their covenant time and again. But God never sent messengers to the neighbors, and the neighbors grew jealous and filled with anger and hate. In time, God loved the family so much that he wanted to have his son meet the family. So God sent his son. But the neighbors were jealous because God did not send his son to meet the neighbors. More generations passed, and the family, learning just how much God loved them, shared the good news of God's son with the world. But the neighbors had created gods for themselves because they were jealous the Son of God had not personally come to them. Finally, one young neighbor man was fed up. He was tired of seeing the family have the covenant and the family get visited by the Son of God. He had had enough, and he decided he would make his God greater than the God of the family. He began making up stories because of his sharp wit. He was so mad at the God of the family that he made up his own story of a God who had no son. Never again would he feel the rejection of not being good enough for God to send his son for a visit to the neighbors. He claimed his stories came from the God of the neighbors, who was greater than the God of the family. He taught his followers to say, "Our idol is greater than the God of the family." But his followers said that was way too long to say and did not have good rhythm, and you could not dance to it. So he shortened it to just, "Our God is greater." And he told his followers, "You are the true believers. This is what our God has said to call you. You are the true believers. All other believers are false." And the true believers would shave their heads and follow their leader and shout, "Our God is greater." But they were not following the God of the family. In fact, they were following a spirit who wanted to be like the God of the family. And the poor neighbor boy did not know he was being used by the spirit that hated the God of the family. And those that followed his religion were good people who wanted to follow the God of the family because they all knew the God of the family was the real God. But they had been convinced that the God of the family did not love them because his son had not come to their house. Little did they know that the son of the God of the family had come so that he could bring gifts to all the families of the world. Not just the family, and not just the neighbors, but the families on every block in every town. But the neighbors fought against the God of the family and held on to their hate because they were taught that God does not have a son. And the God of the family wept because many, many, many people believed the lie that he had no son. And the cult of the true believers refused to listen to the family because every time the true believers spoke of themselves, they said they alone were the true believers. But the family continued to reach out to the neighbors, and over time, some, a few, here and there, the neighbors were accepted into the family, and they would meet the Son of God, who would then introduce them to God. And they learned that God did not really want men to shave their heads. He wanted men to wash their hearts. Hi, neighbor. Thank you for watching my video. Would you like to meet the Son of God? He has told me that He is standing at the door to your heart. He has come to your house, neighbor, and He wants to come in and dine with you. He wants you to know He had to visit the family first, because that is what God promised. But now He is ready to visit every family in the world, including you and yours. Invite the Son of God into your heart to visit, and you won't want Him to leave. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.